I've made a video this evening, 7 December 2021, about this long-wave radio, and I want to add to that video this other video. It's a kind of vlog, but it shows that the circuit works good. And in the earlier video I told about that French radio station, but now I am receiving the BBC on long wave, and that is 198 kilohertz, as far as I know. So the coils are now here in this position, and I have connected directly to the top of the, say, receiving coil, and I will give the link in the text box of this video to the schematic. Well, let me give the schematic. That will take some time. I have to take it out of my room. Sorry for the waiting. This is the schematic here. It was also in the video of this evening. And I've now connected directly to the top of the coil here, not via a 27 picofarad capacitor, so directly to the outside antenna in my garden, and that antenna comes in via a coax cable. It's approximately 10 meters, and thanks to Rob, one of my followers, I now have a complete good reception. Schematic again, without noise, etc., etc. And of course, it's critical that these coils must be moved in a certain position to get to that long wave radio station, in this case the BBC. So I will switch on the radio again.
I rhyme to see myself.
So I think this is quite acceptable for long wave. No noise, almost no noise, at least an acceptable level of noise, anyway.
By Roy Foster.
No need to know. Don't be afraid.
Starting next Monday morning at 9:45 on Radio 4 and BBC Sound.
The new trade border between Great Britain and Northern Ireland being for those on both sides.
I think that's quite good. But let me do an experiment moving the coils, and you will surely see that this radio station, the position of the coils to receive this radio station is critical. Anyway.
That evidence heard today about the government's evacuation of Kabul points to a lack of leadership, urgency, and from your civil service at the Foreign Office for several hours. Described as chaotic. Officials denied that remaining on leave at the time had been a dereliction of duty.
Anyway,
it's emerged that the senior...
That was all that I wanted to show and say. These oscillations, the yelling that you hear, can be set, can be diminished, taken away by tuning here these two potentiometers in the transistor amplifier. Consider this, say, perhaps as a kind of amplifier with three tubes out of the 1920s, but now it is made with three transistors, and we can, that's a good thing of the transistors, we can set the amplification very, very easily. At least in the grounded emitter configuration, by changing the value of the emitter. resistor. Add that emitter resistor. It's here. Here you could set the amplification of this stage. Here you could set the amplification of the second stage. And how good that transistor amplifies depends for a big part on the value of this capacitor. That's now 10 nanofarad. I've searched that out. It's a good value. But for audio, say 20 hertz up to 20 kilohertz, that's approximately 10 microfarad. So that's a big, big value. And now it is a quite low value in a low, much lower magnitude. Anyway, always interesting to listen to radio stations, especially the BBC. It often has quite good information, and I have reread on the World Wide Web that they don't have a long wave station any longer. Perhaps I'm wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong. Anyway,
the crossing between the islands of Ireland and Britain for millennia. It's a body of water which both separates and connects the histories of both places.
I grew up looking out on its murky brown waters from the Wirral Peninsula. My father sailed out across it as a merchant sailor, and like countless others in Merseyside, grandparents and great-grandparents sailed across it from Ireland to start new lives.
Oh, the weight of history that expanse
of water carries. It's extraordinary.